Hello and welcome to this PTGui tutorial series. Today's segment is all about leveling. What do we mean by leveling? Well, leveling refers to the fact that your panoramic output will be leveled and that things that you see in the panorama will be straight and upright, just like they are in the real world. Leveling won't be an issue if you carefully level your panoramic tripod head just before taking your images on location. And in that case, the panorama will come out upright just out of the box. However, this won't work that well if you're using things like viewpoint correction, because typically then your offset image won't be as leveled, or, well, when your tripod head wasn't leveled to begin with. In that case, PTGui needs some additional clues, and we provide those clues by using a new type of control point that you haven't seen so far, and that's the vertical line type control point. There's also horizontal line type control points, but they're a bit special and we'll briefly comment on those later, but for now we'll just focus on the vertical ones. Vertical line type control points are different to the regular ones. Remember, the regular ones that we saw so far are used to pinpoint the same feature in two different images. Well, with the vertical ones now, we're looking at the same image twice, but we're pinpointing something that is truly vertical, and we show that by pinpointing the top and the bottom end of it. The crucial thing here is you need something that is truly vertical in real life, and things like street signs or lampposts aren't all that vertical in real life, so be careful with those. Alright, so this is where we left off last time with the viewpoint correction tutorial. And all the leveling stuff that I'm going to talk about now has nothing to do with the Pro version, it's also part of the standard version. Okay, let's have a look at the panorama editor now. As you can see, after optimizing the panorama, it doesn't come out all that vertical or upright. I can use this button here, and that does a pretty good job. And what this button does actually, it doesn't use any control points or anything, it just purely looks at the yaw pitch and roll angles in the panorama and tries to average them in such a way as to make it straight. This works very well when your tripod head is leveled. In that case, unfortunately, my tripod was pretty well leveled when I shot this panorama, but just to prove my point, here's a counterexample. This looks very straight now, but if I use that button, it makes it all worse, because at that stage I was using a pole and that definitely wasn't leveled. Alright, well, what do we do in this situation? As I said, we need to give PTGui some additional clues, and we do that by using vertical line type control points. So let's hop to the control point editor. Right now I've got two separate images selected here, one and two, and you can see down here the control point type to add is normal. Now watch what happens if I switch to the same image left and right, that automatically jumps to vertical line type, and that's exactly what we want to do. Alright, well, this edge of the tunnel here is definitely vertical, I know that for a fact. And I will add a control point at the top edge and the bottom edge. Of course, it doesn't matter which way around you do it, but it's two separate points on that same vertical line. Then we need to add at least one extra one, and ideally you want to have that about 90 degrees apart. We'll take this panel here, those were also pretty vertical. And just for good measure, and I always recommend that, add some more, just so that any errors that you make a little bit get averaged out between the different lines. And we've got one more down here. We'll pick the bottom edge here and the top edge there. Okay, let's get back to the panorama editor. If I now optimize, that will take those control points that we added into account. And now you can see if I push that button, that actually becomes a little bit less vertical. It's a little bit slanted. But if I optimize again, taking those control points into account, the overall panorama is beautifully leveled and that line is vertical. Alright, so far so good. Now, what about those horizontal line type control points? Well, to understand why they're a little bit more complicated, you need to know that this leveling that PTGui does, it does that on the final assembled panorama. So when it does the leveling, it doesn't change the relative position of the image anymore. It just warps the entire panorama exactly in the same way like you're doing manually in this case here, except it does it automated for you and based on those vertical line type control points. And it does that in the equirectangular projection, so this output that we've got here. The problem is that any horizontal line, as you can see here, is actually bowed, and that's part of the nature of the equirectangular projection. Watch tutorial 4 for more details on that. So that makes it very difficult for using any of those horizontal lines for leveling, except under one very specific situation, and that is when that horizontal line is exactly on the horizon line. But in real life, you very rarely encounter such situations, and that would only be if you're at the beach and you've got the horizon line in view. Well, then you can use that in conjunction with horizontal line type control points. Otherwise, I would just stick to vertical line type control points. All right, that's really all I wanted to show today. Thanks for watching, and catch you at the next tutorial.